Hi guys! Welcome to Tre Josie Channel!
Hi kids! Welcome to Science 4, Quarter 4, Week 4, Lesson 7. For today's lesson, we're going to discuss about the importance of water cycle. Come on! Let's have fun while learning! Here are the objectives. First, identify the different stages of the water cycle. Second, describe the importance of water cycle. Let's have a short review. Please bring out your notebook and answer yes. Write true if the statement is correct and false if it is not. Check your answers. For number one, the water cycle provides for the constant supply of fresh water on Earth. The answer is true. For number two, people in the community cannot live without the occurrence of the water cycle. The answer is true. Number three, water cycle has both good and bad effect to living things. It is true. Number four, water vapor condenses into tiny droplets to form clouds. The answer is true. And lastly, the sun's energy heats water in lakes, rivers, and oceans, causing water particles to rise. The answer is true. I do hope you got a perfect score. Kindly label the different stages of water cycle. Let's see if you are correct. For number one, the answer is evaporation. For number two, the answer is, that's right, condensation. Number three, it is precipitation. And lastly, the answer is collection. Did you get it right, kids? Very good. How many percentage of Earth's surface is covered by water? You're right. The water part of the Earth is called hydrosphere or water sphere. This covers 3/4 of its surface. To better understand our lesson, let's have a group activity. It was entitled, How Important I Am in the Environment. For group 1, you are going to list down 3 importance of water cycle to human. For group 2, you are going to list down 3 importance of water cycle to plants. For group 3, and now, let's have your group presentation. Once again, what is water cycle? Very good. When you say water cycle, it is the continuous movement of water between Earth's water supply and the air. What are the stages of water cycle? You're right. What are the importance of water cycle to human? Very good. The importance of water cycle to human are the following. First, life cannot exist without the water cycle, because we use it for our daily consumptions. So there's no life without water. Next, it improves health and hygiene practices. What are the importance of water cycle to plants? You're right. To plants, it helps the plant to grow healthy, or healthy plant growth, or the development of plants. Second one, it increases production or yield crops. And lastly, it's become the continuous support or supply of fresh water. So if there are enough water for plants, it will grow healthy. What are the importance of water cycle to animals? Very good. So for animals, first, healthy animal growth. Next, continuous supply of fresh water. So if there is a continuous supply of fresh water, there are enough water for drinking. And lastly, what are the importance of water cycle to the environment? You got it right. First, it regulates the temperature on Earth. Next, it purifies water by eliminating the pollutants. Number three, distributes water all over the Earth's surface. And lastly, it increases water storage as ground water. Can life and other environmental processes continue without the water cycle? Why or why not? Correct. Water cycle is important because it transforms salty water into fresh water during precipitation process. Water cycle is also known as hydrologic cycle. It describes how water evaporates from the surface of the earth, rises into the atmosphere, cools and condenses into clouds, and falls again to the earth's surface as precipitation in the form of rain, snow, hail, or sleet. For better understanding, please answer this on your notebook. Identify the importance of water cycle. Okay, you are going to write human, plants, animals, or environment on the blank. You may now begin. Let's check your answers. For number one, use for daily activities. The answer is human. For number two, growing population of animals, it is animals. Number three, plants growing healthy. Of course, it is for plants. Number four, increased water storage on groundwater. The answer is environment. And number five, improve hygiene practices. Of course, the answer is human. I do hope you got a perfect score. And for your assignment, please answer this in your science notebook. You live in the community where most of the people earn a living through farming vegetables and fruits. One day, you notice that some of the plants are withered and wilted. What do you think is the reason why? That's all for today, kids. Thank you, kids, for listening. See you again next time. Stay safe, everyone. God bless.
Please don't forget to like, comment, and share. Please also click the subscribe button. Thank you.